the sky as much as it was a battle of grunts on the ground. And with few large-scale engagements, innovative air-ground tactics became an imperative. For the Marines on the ground, Marine pilots attacked enemy positions while flying full speed at treetop level. They knocked out hidden enemy supply lines, inserted and extracted patrols from dense jungle growth, and pulled out medevacs from places and situations where no one expected helicopters to go. The development of direct air support control brought Marine air ground teamwork to a new level.
Cairo, 28014, over.
This is 8-1, roger out.
Each center within the Fire Support Coordination Center and Division Command Post helped orchestrate a complex array of air, ground, and seaborne firepower. Six Marine airmen, helicopters, artillery, offshore naval guns, helped us support the fall of the country.
Not going to go to the back of the plane. served as a radio operator with an artillery forward observer team on Hill 881 South. On his 19th birthday, the North Vietnamese flag.
I had one man looking up
essentially in the self-sponsored area, the constellation has been moving in this direction. There are obviously more than one aircraft, right?
There has been nothing like it since President Roosevelt's visit to North Africa in the wartime year of 1943.
Shooting gave me the confidence in my country and the cause of righteousness and freedom for which we were fighting. I had no feelings. I was not nervous.
The Green Arrow Marines were quick to recognize and apply emerging technologies into a variety of special use aircraft. Days and nights, things only got worse. The demonic cold and ferocious Chinese attacks exacted terrible tolls. The threat of annihilation hung over the chosen Marines. These were hardships that few Americans had ever endured. Task Force Faith, the army forces on the east side of the Russian War, were cut off and nearly annihilated. Those who escaped did so across the ice. The ferocity of Task Force Drysdale's journey through Hellfire Valley, where a combined force of U.S. Marines, Army, and British Royal Marines was savagely battered by Chinese forces holding the surrounding high ground. And nearby was planned and rescued from the Marines.
Speed top down, 8-0. part of the approach channel, that's not even enough room to turn a ship around it.
God forbid one was hit and foundered.
The tide wall would run 2 to 3 hours to get in. Then they would be stranded in only 27 minutes of daylight to secure themselves against a city the size of Omaha.
Commander, you've taught me all I ever dreamed of knowing about tides. My confidence in the Navy is complete. And in fact, I seem to have more confidence in the Navy than the Navy has in itself. The Navy's rich experience in staging numerous amphibious landings under my command in the Pacific or in the Lake, frequently under similar difficulties, leaves me with little doubt in my story. I never thought the day would come when the Navy would be unable to support the Army in a top green.
X-Day was set for December 7, 1941. The Japanese task force arrived undetected, right on schedule. And within hours, America would be at war.
Right now. devastating fire. 100 years, the Japanese commander had Keiji Shibasaki assured his hardworking troops.
The second Marine Division will do in advance. And they will face a very difficult trial. Nobody's idea is that the Japanese will track many forces from all the areas.
The Japanese leaders knew that was going to be answered by the U.S. Pacific Fleet, headquartered in Pearl Harbor, Hawaii.
Thank you. for developing self-confidence and discipline where there is none.
Let's go! 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 Let's